Hey guys, it's Avery from VideoBlend, and today we're going to be looking at all of Android N's new features. Okay, before we get started, there's one thing I'd like to point out. Not everything that's new in Android N is going to be visible to the human eye. Meaning, there's a lot of new performance improvements and battery saving options and stuff like that, which you can't actually see. They're going to affect you in day-to-day use, but you're not going to be able to notice them right off the bat. So that kind of stuff I'll go over first. First, there's a new JIT compiler. What that means is it's basically just a new compiler as far as assembling updates for your phone, which means you're going to get a lot faster updates. And one new introduction with Android N is seamless updates. This isn't going to be on every device, but mainly the Nexus devices. Seamless updates basically allows Android N to install updates in the background, so you don't have to restart your phone in order for the updates to apply. There's also now Vulkan API support, which is going to be a new graphics API, which is going to get you better performance in future games which feature Vulkan Graphics. Now, Vulkan Graphics aren't in many of the current Android games because very few phones actually support them until Android N. So that's going to be something that we'll see happen over the next year. Finally, Android is also going to introduce a new VR mode. What that's going to allow you to do is be able to control any sort of Android system controls or apps and all sorts of stuff like that through a VR headset, so you don't have to launch a VR compatible app or game and then control stuff through there. You can actually even use your home screen through Android VR. Now, official support for Android VR isn't going to be coming out until later this year, so I'm not going to be covering anything else related to that in this video. And right before we get into the actual visible changes, there are a few extra things. First, there's going to be Android Backup, which is going to now start backing up more settings in your device. There's going to be more accessibility options, including customizable display size and mono output. And finally, Android for Work, which I'm not going to show you, but you can actually check it out yourself. It's going to allow you to enable a work mode and turn off notifications from certain apps. And now let's get started with the actual visible changes. The first one is going to be a new data saver option. What this is going to allow you to do is, if enabled, Data Saver will turn off background data for any selected apps, and you'll also be able to specify which apps you want background data to still run on. What this will allow you to do is, if you know you're running low on data, or you're just afraid to use extra data, you can enable this option, and it will basically only use data in the app that you have open. Obviously, like I said, you can specify certain apps to always have data running. By default, Google Play Services is enabled, and you can do this with other apps like Snapchat or Hangouts or anything that you want to still receive notifications from. But this will definitely help you save a lot of data, and I've definitely noticed a big data saving improvement. There's also going to be what I'd like to call DOES 2.0. Now, DOES in Android 6.0 disabled background processes when your phone was idle and not moving, like on a table or on the floor or plugged in, but now this is going to happen whenever your phone screen is off. You'll also now see a big change in the quick settings menu. You can see the basic quick settings just at the top of your screen when you swipe down for your notifications, but if you swipe down again, you'll be able to see all of your quick settings in an easier to view mode. You can even have multiple pages of them. This will allow you to either tap on one and see more information, or hold down on one of the options to actually bring up that area in the settings app. You can also edit this quick setting area to have the certain settings that you use the most, and this way you'll have access to those easier than the other ones. Android N also now supports the new Unicode 9 emoji. And one of the biggest new features, especially for tablets, is split screen mode. This is done just by opening up an app that you want to use, and then holding down on the multitasking button. This will allow you to choose another app from your multitasking menu to run on the other half of the screen. If you're in portrait mode, this will run the second app on the bottom half of the screen, and if you're in landscape mode, this will run the second app on the right half of the screen. One minor change, which is actually very noticeable, that Google hasn't really emphasized, is that now the settings menu is so much easier to understand because you'll see quick information about each setting beneath the title, so you don't even have to tap on that setting area in order to figure out what your settings are currently set to. For example, under Wi-Fi, you'll see what network you're connected to. Under Bluetooth, you'll see what device you're connected to. And under data usage, you'll see how much data you've used so far this month. Now, I realize this next part might be a little bit too long to put into this video, so I'm going to make a separate video about this, especially because this is one of my favorite parts about Android, but there is a new Easter egg this year. The past 2 years, there's been mostly just Flappy Bird clones with the new Android logo every year, and just different styles of the game, but this year, we have a strange new game. By going into the Android 7.0 Easter egg menu, tapping a bunch of times on the Android N logo, and then holding down on it, you'll see a cat emoji pop up near the bottom of the screen. This activates the Easter egg. I'm going to make a separate video you'll see in the upper right hand corner on what this does. Now, nearing the end of this video, there's two main things that I'd like to point out with the new version of Android. The first one is going to be the ability to customize how important notifications are and how you want to be alerted about them. In the example you'll see on the screen now, I'm going to hold down on the notification that tells me that I'm connected to my home Wi-Fi network, and with this notification, it'll bring up three options. I can choose to show notifications from this app silently, block all of its notifications, or just the regular default option, don't silence or block any of the notifications. This will change the settings for all future notifications from this app, so if there's an app that bugs you all the time and your phone's always vibrating, you can set it to show notifications silently and you won't be annoyed so often. And I've saved one of my favorite features for last. This is the ability to quick reply to text notifications. Now, I know this is going to be migrated to more apps soon, but right now it's only available through texting apps like the default Messenger or what I use, Google Hangouts. If you get a text from someone, it'll pop up in the top of the screen as a banner notification, just like in Android 6. But now in Android 7, you'll see a little reply button, which will actually allow you to reply to the text directly on the screen without opening up the app at all. You can even send it right there. I have noticed a slight glitch about this, being the notification actually stays in your notifications drawer, it doesn't disappear after you reply to it. Sometimes it glitches out and does disappear, but only after a certain amount of time. So yes, Android N is the best version of Android yet, with all sorts of features which only existed in other custom skins of Android. But even after the final release of Android N, I don't feel like all the bugs have been worked out yet, and that is probably best for now because it's only available on a few Nexus phones at the moment. Google has announced that they're working on bug patches to be released through the end of this year, so by the time that you get Android N on your phone, it should be running buttery smooth. I'd give Android N a solid 8 out of 10 at this point, as there were a few features which Google promised which still haven't been added, like a native night mode for your eyes, and it's obvious that all the glitches and bugs haven't been 100% fixed at this point. So, this is only my initial review of Android N, and after those patches come out, I will make sure that I follow up on those, because there's going to be quite a few of them. And also, don't forget to check out my video on the Android Easter egg, because I think it's pretty cool, and also pretty cute. So that video is going to be, again, in upper right-hand corner, also in the comments. Feel free to subscribe to my channel and like this video if you enjoyed it. Dislike it if you didn't like it, and don't be scared to ask me any questions in the comments. I usually get back to all comments within 24 hours. Anyways, thanks guys so much for watching this video. I really appreciate all the support I'm getting, and I hope you guys have a great day.